Stand by for manual transmission in 3, 2, 1.
07 Commanders, Manus Dextra here with my Open Beta 2 Fleet Carrier review for Elite Dangerous. So I'm mostly interested in using this thing for exploration, and I wanted to see what it would be like to move one long distances, paying particular attention to time, jump fuel costs, and how traveling with a carrier helps or hinders the process of exploring. And that will be the focus of this video. To start, I went to one of the less popular systems to purchase my carrier in hopes of avoiding performance problems many players reported in more popular and congested systems like DSO. I chose a system called Nemedes to purchase mine. It wasn't crowded and I had no problems here at all. Check the description for a link to a list of star systems where you can buy carriers. While you're there, as always, like, comment, and subscribe for more Elite Dangerous content. Next, I added all my additional services. I ended up getting almost everything except refueling, because that's what fuel scoops are for, the redemption office, and the black market. Total cost for the carrier and upgrades was somewhere around 5.8 billion credits, with a weekly upkeep cost of about 21 million credits. Then I did a bit more searching to find a system where I could buy fuel. You should be able to find fuel for sale in systems with a refinery economy. Systems with higher populations should have more fuel on offer. I chose Fong Wang because it's close to Jameson Memorial, where all my ships are stored. I had all my ships transferred from there while I made about 10 trips hauling fuel between the station and the carrier in my cutter, which I refitted for maximum cargo capacity. I ended up buying about 9,000 tons of tritium at a cost of about 42,000 credits per ton for a total cost of 378 million credits. This put my total startup costs at just about 6.2 billion. Now, fueled up with all ships transferred, I was finally ready to go out exploring. I picked a destination about 11,000 light years away and started traveling. My initial plan was to explore, scout for fuel sources, and mine along the way. I did this for about the first 2,000 light years or so, and tritium hotspots seemed to be fairly common and easy to find. I summoned my carrier to one of these spots, docked, and switched from my DBX to an Anaconda set up to mine with lasers and subsurface missiles. Then I set a 1 hour timer and started laser mining. This got me about 120 tons of tritium. After this, I mined for another hour trying to subsurface mine as much as possible. Doing this, I only managed to collect about 60 tons of fuel. Apparently, subsurface mining is bugged right now and yields should be higher when this update goes live. But even so, I didn't find many rocks with subsurface deposits, and I'm not confident that this method will be much better than laser mining. My carrier used about 220 tons of fuel per jump on average. So, if I wanted to mine all my fuel, it would take me about 2 hours per jump with no time left to explore at a rate of 120 tons per hour. Even if I liked mining, and I don't, this wouldn't be practical. So, I gave up on mining and I concentrated on exploring while jumping the carrier to see how quickly I could get to my destination. This process went much better. I refueled the carrier and ordered it to jump. Then I got back in my DBX and started exploring along the same route as my carrier. Every time the carrier reported a completed jump, I'd order it to jump again remotely while I continued to explore. Doing this, the carrier would usually end up about 1,000 light years ahead of me before running out of fuel. When this happened, I'd stop exploring and jump to the carrier as quickly as possible to get it refueled and moving again. Then I'd go back to exploring and repeat the same process. If you want to make money exploring, it takes time. As long as the carrier can travel faster than I can explore, I'm happy. And with the current FSD cycle times of 20 minutes per jump, it can do that. I finally got to my destination after about 10 hours or so. If I hadn't spent 2 hours mining, the trip would have taken about 8. Again, I think this is fine. If I had taken the time to thoroughly explore all the systems along this route and map all the valuable planets, it would have taken me even longer to get there. At my destination, I checked to see how much fuel I actually consumed. It was about 5,000 tons. At 42,000 credits per ton, this put fuel costs for the trip at around 200 million credits. Then I cashed in all my UC data, and I was very disappointed to discover that after discounts, I only made about 100 million credits. So I actually went in the hole by 100 million credits for the trip. This is pretty bad for me, since exploring is the main way I make money in the game. But to be totally fair, I did spend a lot of time looking for tritium hotspots and mapping icy rings. And I also skipped a lot of systems just to keep up with the carrier. I know from experience that I can make between 20 and 30 million credits per hour exploring, so I'm pretty sure that I could have covered the cost of fuel and probably made a small profit with a bit more focus and effort. Still, as a commander who makes most of his money from exploring, this is not ideal. From this, it seems pretty clear that using a carrier could cut into profits from exploring significantly. This hasn't totally put me off of using a carrier, but it will greatly affect how I use the carrier and how often I take it with me on a trip. It should still be useful as a remote base, but you'll need to keep it in a single spot for a long time while you explore the surrounding region thoroughly to turn a decent profit. So at this point, I think carriers are marginally viable for exploration, and more than that, if you're not concerned with making maximum profits. Personally, I hope they rebalance the jump fuel requirements before carriers go live, but even if they don't, I'll still buy one just to see what I can do with it. As I'm recording this, it's May 18th. During this last week of the beta, ending on the 26th, you should be able to purchase a carrier for only 1 million credits. So I'd say go get one and try it out for yourself, and let me know what you think of it in the comments below. Until next time, Commanders!
Mr. Dextra thanks you for your cooperation. You will now be released from manual control. Mr. Dextra thanks you for your cooperation.